Hi, I'm Torben Jansen from thoughtsonjava.org with the new Hibernate tip. Today I will answer a common Hibernate question about element collections. But before we talk about it in detail, please subscribe and hit the bell icon to get new Hibernate tip videos every week. So here's today's question. We are using an element collection to model a list of values on one of our entities. Now we need to implement a new use case for which we need to select entities which element collection contains a specific value. How can we do that? You can use the element collection annotation to store a list of values as an entity attribute without needing to model an additional entity. That might look like a great feature, but it has a few downsides, as I explained in a previous Hibernate tip. I therefore don't recommend to use an element collection, but to instead model an association with an additional entity. If you decide to use an element collection anyways, or if you just can change the existing code, you can reference its elements similarly as you would do it with a modeled association. Let's take a look at a simple example. Here you can see an author entity that uses an element collection to map a list of phone numbers to the phone numbers attribute. Let's use a JPQL query to select the author entity that belongs to a given phone number. You can do that by first joining the entity with the element collection before you reference the elements in the WHERE clause. It requires a little more code, but you can do the same with the criteria query. The author underscore class is part of the JPA meta model and enables you to reference the attributes of the author entity in a type-safe way. I explained it in more details in Create TypeSafe Queries with the JPA Static Meta Model. Hibernate generates the following SQL statement for both queries. Even though the phone numbers are not modeled as a separate entity, Hibernate maps them to the author underscore phone numbers table. That's why you need to join them in your query before you can reference the elements in the WHERE clause. Before we end this video, please be aware of the downsides of element collections. I explained them in the video How to persist a list of strings as an element collection. I will add the link to it to the video description. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like an ebook about the Java 8 support in Hibernate, a printable PDF version of this Hibernate tip, lots of cheat sheets, and a video course. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. See you next week for a new Hibernate tip, and if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!